Hello there and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a fun new nail product. They are the Dashing Diva Gloss Strips. And my best friend gave me my first package of these for my birthday. I put them on while she was here, wore them that entire week, then wore them to Tennessee, swam in the pool, kayaked in the lake, all the airport travel, came home, and they still looked great. In fact, I'm going to show you in a moment how they looked at the end of 14 days and then how easy they were to remove. So that sold me on these nail strips and I promptly went out and bought more of them. So at the end of this video, I'm gonna actually show you how they apply. So I know this is gonna seem a little backwards, but sometimes the wear and how something is easily or not easily removed determines whether I want to do it again. So we're going to start there and then I'm going to show you how I applied this set that I have on my nails. And then I will round out this video with a few final tips that I've learned along the way. So let's get started and see how these looked after 14 days. Okay, so on my right hand, I have a little chip on my index finger and a little wear on my ring finger, but overall, these look pretty good after 14 days. My left hand, there's less wear, but you can see up close how much my nails have grown out, but the clear part of the strip disguises that. So to remove these, I just took a little bit of nail polish remover, and this is by Cutex brand, and put some of that on a cotton ball, and then just pressed a little bit of that solution into the cuticle part of the nail. So you wanna just loosen up the adhesion of that strip at the base of the nail. And then I'm taking a cuticle pusher just to help pull up the edge of that nail strip. So you can use your fingernails for this. If your nails are longer than mine, it might be easier. But then you wanna just gently, and I mean gently, don't rip it off really quickly. You wanna just gently pull that strip all the way off the nail and you'll see it comes off completely clean and there is no damage to the nail. So as I continued to finish up removing these, every single one of these strips came off in one piece. I didn't have any straggle pieces, and more importantly, I did not have to soak my nails in acetone or remover or anything. And here are my finished nails. There is no damage whatsoever. But I kind of want to put some new ones on. So this is the style Rose Sparkle, and I love the look of these. So what you're going to need is obviously a set of the gloss strips and then rubbing alcohol, a cuticle pusher, and a cotton round or a cotton ball. So it's really important to push down your cuticles because you want those, you want to be able to get the strips as close to your cuticle as possible, but you definitely don't want to apply them on top of your cuticle. So make sure those are all pushed down. And then you're going to take a little bit of rubbing alcohol and put this on all of your nails and let it dry. This is going to help make sure that there is no extra oils or any extra moisture in your nails, which would make your strips come off quicker. So the set looks like this. It comes with a couple extra mirrored pages. It comes with a complete set of directions. You can read these in case you forget anything I tell you here. It comes with a fingernail file that is pink on one side and on the other side is white, and that is going to be important. So we'll talk about that in a moment, but here you have the strips. And don't forget, there is a secret hidden strip behind that mirrored one, and I actually threw away my first one because I didn't realize there was an extra strip under there, so don't do that. And then there are three different types of designs in each packet. So you usually have one, these two strips that have one main color, and then you've got four different design options. So you just want to go through and create your own random design. Figure out which design, what color you want to put on which nail. I kind of sometimes use the size of the strips to help determine what order I want them to go in. For your thumbs, you're pretty much going to need to use the main color for those, but these other designs you can pretty much use on the rest of your nails. So once I've figured out my design,
kind of like to lay them out, and then we're going to begin. So I'm starting off with my thumb, and you want to place it in the center and as close to the cuticle as possible. Press out from the center to either edge, and then work it towards the edge of your nail. And you want to just keep pressing, pressing, pressing. And as you go, you're going to start pulling that strip kind of over the edge of your nail. And you're going to create kind of a hard edge there. And this, you can clip off that excess portion if you want to, but I just found it just as easy to go in with the file. So let me switch to the index finger and I'll show you the whole process here. So I decided on this design for my index finger. So again, make sure you get it in the center of the nail and as close to the cuticle, press it out, press it towards the tip of the nail, fold that edge over. And then as I told you, when you saw that fingernail file, you are going to want to go with the white side and you're going to file in one direction. I like to file down and it looks like I'm putting a lot of pressure here. I'm really not, but you're going to file down and use that edge of your nail to help cut the nail strip. So you want to just go all the way across the edge of the nail, make sure it is completely separated from your nail, and then pull off the excess. Then you want to switch to the pink side of the file, and this is just a really fine grit. This is going to make it the edge super smooth, and I think it also helps it wear better. If you get any extra little stragglers on the edge, go back to the white side, and then just make sure you finish with the pink. And there you go, you have another strip applied. So I decided again to kind of really go random on this set. So I'm doing the silver sparkle here in the middle finger and the process just continues. Again, the important thing is you really want to make sure you smooth it over the edge and don't pull too hard on the strip over the edge, but you do want to just make sure that the edge is exposed of your nail and then file away. And as you're filing, just make sure you don't start pulling away the strip of that excess strip until you're sure that it is completely separated. Then go in with that pink side and smooth everything out. Run your finger over it. You will be able to tell if it's nice and smooth, and time to move on to the next one. So you can see this process goes very quickly. Once you kind of make your decision of which one's going on which nail, you do want to choose a size. If you're kind of in between sizes, go with a size that's slightly smaller because you don't want any overlap to stick on your skin or on your cuticle. So that's just a little tip. I've learned this the hard way. but again, they go on very easily. You can see they really adhere well. And then after you are all done applying, you want to make sure you wait. I think it says in this instructions about an hour before you put on any hand moisturizer or anything, just to kind of let that adhesive really stick and bond to the nail. So now onto the final nail, this beautiful pink sparkle. I just couldn't resist. And even though these look really textury and glittery, they're super smooth on the surface. So just finish off the filing here. And then make sure it's all separated before pulling it off. One final smoothing with the file. And then we have one hand completely done. And it really only took probably about 5 minutes or so per hand. And there you go. That's the design for the left hand. Now the right hand, I decided to change up slightly. And so this is how kind of my finished look is between the two hands, but I really love how it came out. And then your excess ones, you want to just put back in your package. You can see how many I have left over. So I've got plenty to do another design.
Now these gel strips do come in a wide variety of colors and patterns. It just depends on where you purchase them. I have seen them at both Walmart and Target, and then online on Amazon. and also on the Dashing Diva website. I've not personally shopped their website, but I did look on there and they have a ton more options. But it seems like the pricing is around the $7 mark and you do get 34 strips. Just make sure that you look for that hidden layer of strips below this one here. And so therefore, I do feel like you can get at least two good full wears out of one package. And then if you mix and match different ones from different packages, I think you can even get more wear out of that one package. So I do feel like the price point, especially for the longevity of wear, is actually really good. Now, a couple of tips. I tried with this current set that I have here, I just did this before coming on the video because my nails were starting to get a little long. And you know, I'm a pianist, so long nails don't work. And so I needed to trim them, and I gave them a trim with nail scissors. I just think that's a little bit easier. And then I went back with my nail file that comes in the kit with the pink side and just gently went over the edge, and that smoothed out the edge. And I think that really helped them look fresh. And the outgrowth, I don't have too much growth showing here yet. But that brings up the other point, is if you are somebody whose nails grow pretty quickly, you may want to look for designs like that first pair I showed, which is the In the Blush, that has a clear end to it, because that is not going to show the growth here at the cuticle nearly as much. And finally, I have found these to be pretty durable. However, I did discover the one way that these will start pulling off the edge if you're not careful. And that is if you are somebody who likes to peel off sticky labels, or what happened to me, I was opening up a mail package and it was really tight. The box was really tightly closed and I was trying to use my thumb to kind of pull open the box. Well, by really putting a lot of force here at the tip and pressing up like that, it did start to peel up the strip. So just know you're gonna have to use a little extra care if you're trying to take off labels or trying to open things that require you to kind of press your nail into them. You might wanna pull out a pair of tweezers, and that will make sure that your manicure stays nice and sealed at the end of the nail. All right, so that wraps up this video. I hope that it was helpful for you. For those of you that struggle to keep polish on their nails, hopefully I've given you a new option to try. Thank you as always so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.